As probably everybody knows, we have a very special birthday this week, and I know it's Miss Amy's favorite time of year when she gets to come out in front of everybody because she just loves the spotlight. So I put together a 10-minute speech tonight, and I think the slideshow too, I think. And after that, Pastor wrote a poem he'd like to read you, and then, no, not really. But if you would, Miss Donna's going to bring up we just want to do something special for you as a church. I know the ladies got together. And we're doing something for you each day this month instead of a social or whatever, something different. But we just want to tell you we love you and have a happy birthday and have a gift certificate bouquet, I think that's what you call it. And just I don't know. But just have a good time shopping and enjoy yourself. And we love you. We appreciate you a lot. And we just you mean a lot to us. So we just want to let you know. Happy birthday.
But Charlie, why don't you come out? Let's sing "Happy Birthday" to Miss Amy here. And John, can you play that for us real quick? Or just give us a chord. That'll be fine.
All together. I know you can sing "Happy Birthday," right? Even if he can't play, we can still sing it. All together, happy birthday to you, Miss Amy. All right, here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Miss Amy. Happy birthday to you. Good job singing. There's no doubt about it.
Well, I just wanted to give a testimony. And tonight I was kind of thinking ahead to testimony time. I didn't know this was going to happen. But I just first of all want to say thank you. And to all the ladies that have just this month just really just been a blessing and encouragement every day. It's just been very thoughtful and very sweet. And I know those ladies that headed that up, I really appreciate that. And I really appreciate the no social. That's just even a bigger blessing because that's just not my thing. But this year I was thinking this morning when the girls and I were singing about that song, He's Been Faithful. And in about a week, it'll be a year since I was diagnosed with cancer. And this past year has just been amazing to see how faithful the Lord has been through it all. And a great part of that is my family, of course. I'm just so thankful for my husband, who's been there every step of the way through every surgery. And my mother and father-in-law, I know they're over next door tonight, but always coming and sitting with him through every surgery, and my children. But another great part is my church family. And all the meals that were brought and all the prayers and the cards. And, you know, it just really, it was a piece of cake this last year. You know, when I first was diagnosed, I was really overwhelmed and not sure of everything. And the Lord was just so faithful and gave such grace. And I'm just so thankful for our church family. And I just really appreciate all that you've done. Thank you.